Are you getting ready to launch into Shopify? Whether you're switching e-commerce platforms, coming from brick and mortar, or just starting out, then this video is for you. I'm Manuela with Plytix. Today, I'm going to give you an overview of what product information Shopify asks for and show you the four methods you can use to bring your products and their contents into your Shopify store. To start, it's important to know that Shopify has strict criteria for listing your products to fit even a basic store setup. So if you want to get started quickly on Shopify, you have to make sure that your product data is correctly formatted for Shopify. You probably already have that data somewhere. Maybe in spreadsheets, another e-commerce platform, or in a product information management system, in which case smart thinking. Now, the first step is to get all that data together and get it ready. So let's look at the fields that Shopify needs. Title, or the name of the product that your customers will see. For example, I might call this the Dear Excel sweatshirt. Description, to help your customers understand what your product is. This can include HTML content and embedded media. Pricing information, like product price, discounted price, prices in different currencies, and any tax information. Inventory information, such as product SKU, barcode, and quantity. Shipping information, such as weight, country of origin, HS code, and fulfillment service when it's a physical product. Variant information, which is when your product comes in different options like size or color. Product status, which tells Shopify if your product is in draft mode when you still need to make edits to it, if it's in active mode when your product is ready to appear on your store, or if it's archived when your product is no longer on sale. Vendor information, which would be the manufacturer or the wholesaler name. Product type, which is a top level category for your products. For example, this sweater might be under clothing. Collections, unlike product type, which is limited to one option, your product can be included in many different collections, like short sleeve, summer essentials, under 10, and so on. And last but not least, tags. Tags are searchable keywords that will help your customers find your products. In addition to these, it's important to use rich media content to help your customers visualize a product and get a better feel for what is being offered. These can include product images, videos, instructional guides, specification sheets, and more. All of these elements help enhance the customer experience and make it much easier for online shoppers to make a decision. Now that you know the fields that Shopify asks for, the next step would be to gather all this information in one place and have it ready. This will speed up the process of creating products in your Shopify store. Remember, making sure you have accurate, detailed, and consistent data is crucial when creating an online store. This will help you build trust with buyers. But managing all this data can get messy, so make sure you set up a central source of truth for all your product information. This will make it easier when you need to update your listings, or better yet, when you decide to add more products to your repertoire. Now let's look at the four methods of adding products to your Shopify store. Each method has its pros and cons, and while some of these methods are very straightforward, it doesn't necessarily mean that it's the best option. So let's take a look at how they rank from least to most efficient. Number four, manually adding products into Shopify. This is a very straightforward way of adding products into your store. Shopify provides you with the fields and you just have to fill them in with the corresponding information. However, I have to say this is by far the least efficient way to go. Adding products one by one is okay if you only have a handful of products, but it does take time. So if your product catalog is a bit more extensive, you'll find yourself spending hours, if not days, getting all of this information in. It's a very time-consuming process. Not to mention, it makes your data more susceptible to human errors like typos. And remember, whenever you need to update your listings, that'll be another block of time spent manually updating each product. Number three, importing products into Shopify via a CSV sheet. Now, this is definitely more efficient than adding products manually one by one because it means you're able to import products in bulk. But while this speeds up the process of getting your products into your store, it's still not the best option. Even if you already have all your product information in different spreadsheets and systems, you'll need to copy that over into a new sheet that's specific for Shopify. This CSV file will need to follow Shopify's template, and that's not even the hard part. You'll also need to restructure your product content to fit Shopify's requirements, especially when it comes to products with variations like different colors or sizes. Maintenance is also a bit more tedious when importing CSV files. You'll need to keep an external spreadsheet backup that you keep up to date. This is because when updating products via CSV, it will overwrite all the information that's already created in Shopify for that product. So if it doesn't match, you might end up with incorrect information. Number two, using a third-party app. There are many third-party apps that help bring your data into Shopify. These apps speed up the process of creating and updating your products in your store. They let you bring in product data into Shopify via URL feeds, FTP servers, or even by uploading a file. These apps allow you to map columns in your spreadsheet to Shopify fields. So, for example, you can import a file that a supplier sent you without needing to rename or reformat any column headers. What's more, many of these apps let you set up scheduled imports. You'll still need to make sure the data you're importing into Shopify is up to date and that you're not accidentally overwriting anything, but it is a time saver. Last, but definitely not least, at number one, you can sync data directly from a product information management or PIM system into your Shopify stores. This is probably the most efficient way of creating and updating products in Shopify. This is because a PIM system is a single source of truth where you and your team can work on and optimize product content. So you can keep an updated record of product information and assets or rich media and automatically send them out to your Shopify stores and all your other marketing and sales channels. So look for PIM platforms that integrate directly with Shopify. This can save you a lot of time and effort because you can set scheduled automated feeds to make batch updates to your product data and images. This is especially important if you manage multiple Shopify stores and need consistent content across each of them. It's even more important if you sell or plan to sell on marketplaces. The effort required to juggle all this product content is insignificant with PIM, making it easier for you to grow your business and expand on your sales opportunities. Want to see a step-by-step tutorial on how to add products to your Shopify store using each of these methods? Hit subscribe and let me know which one you'd like to see first in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and I'll see you next time.